Like, all I'm looking for at level 5 is 10 speed. That's like, I'm just asking for a 50-50 chance there. So I like how in with the palettes, the default palettes, the character is red and blue, and the character is green and red. So I wonder what color the character would be in Pokemon Green. Whoops. Didn't mean to do that on the splits. You don't sync music, but the text boxes are not online. Yes, this is a full game attempt. Still got K again, somehow. Tens all around. I'll take it. It's good speed regardless. Oh, they got desynced. Oh. Well then. Kinda produces a an echo effect. Ah, they didn't need two tulips there. Please crit blue. Not you, well, sorry. I need to score the crit. I didn't get to see my stats there. But it looks like 11. TCR basically synced up again. Not intentionally. I usually want to have blue a bit further ahead. Because my first save spot for blue versus red is blue's further. Good thing is I didn't have to use the potion in either game. More importantly, red. Because potion placement is going to matter. Learn that the hard way. Having an equivalent potion placement helps quite a bit. And I realized both of them didn't get any encounters. What is this? I know the RNG is different between both, but still. What is this? Okay, that's one. Okay, that one's fightable. That one I'm not gonna fight yet. Ooh, that was close. That's gonna hurt a little bit. Think if I did not use the potion. Why? The game just couldn't let me talk to Oak. Wanna yellow that. Why? This is getting shat on really hard. Really? No encounters? I might as well look for it because Blue's still behind. Pro menu there, Kappa. Like I said, Blue's a little bit further off from where its ideal location. Oh geez, what do you mean by oh geez? First save spot, in case I make a mistake on the Weedle. And, also make sure I get a good naming for Nidoran. Nice! That's one Tail Whip. Total gold split. First encounter, first ball. Though it wasn't a yellow ball. They look subpar. Like, my special DB could be lower than my now my attack DB can be higher than my special DB, which is not what I want to see. Okay, good save spot. I don't think... Oh, I think 15 special would beat Brock easily. I don't think I need to heal. If I do, well, I know what to do. One for that. Yeah, I don't need to heal. Two. Unlucky poison. I'm gonna have to heal here for red. That is in range for a Weedle crit. Okay, that's good special. Walk out of forest first before I walk anywhere else. Let's avoid the grass too while I'm at it. Oh, I forgot to put on Brock. Oh, that's too many. I thought the wrong amount. Yeah, it was supposed to be potions I needed. Press up. I didn't heal, but that's okay. I'll take it. I thought it was change the move selection there. Bide. I probably would have to heal now. That is an unsafe range. Oh, I didn't see my stats. Attack. Ooh, whatever. Nice. That's like exact potion health there. Okay. Walk up. Options. Please. Shift. Item. Potion. Potion this up. Pokedex to here. So I could freely move in red by 10 potions. Cause this next fight for blue is scary too. Bubble that. That's right. It's special first. Down. Potion. Okay, I'll desync them. So I can use the Leer here. Well, I'll use the last bubble here. Between turns, I can just heal because he's guaranteed to hit one more wrap, so I might as well just heal as a passing turn. Okay, good. I got the desync there. Nicely done. Good. Ow, that actually did hurt quite a bit. Please don't quick attack. Okay, good. He's faster. Okay, that was lucky there. I was not paying attention to blue. Well, at least I wasn't really paying attention to blue. Oh, I didn't Leer yet. Forgot. You have to desync them. I'm gonna tackle that Caterpie because I have low stats for special. Nice how they lined up like that. Did plan it out. Okay, make sure you get to the next fight first. So I don't have to do mimic movements. I can't mimic movements. They are one fight apart. Okay, now Nidoran, please crit. Nidoran, please crit. No, don't gel in this. Okay, I'm gonna switch to tackle then. That's the cost of gel missing there. I'm gonna run out of heart attack soon. Six is not a lot. Why? Game is doesn't like me today. If I had like another move for the upcoming fight in red, I would totally do it, but I can't. This is the farthest I've gone in blue ahead of red in a while, in this early of the game. I am gonna tackle that. That tackle is weak. Trying to mix it not too hard. heal. At least I'm still faster than the Metapod. Did I get... Never mind. I got a pair. I'm getting a pair of strats now. So now he learns Poison Sting, so yeah. That should be the last one I need to catch in blue. Nice, how that lines up. Hey, it's a Geodude. A Geobro. Let me get to this. Never mind. Get out. Never mind. Is this really 151? Now this is going to be specific movement for blue. I don't need to fight another Geobro. Did I heal in red? No, I did not. Yeah, that's what I thought. Cause like, I didn't hear the music. Nice! Now they both got Paris. Nice crit. Use this moment to heal. Not first of all, Paris. Not second ball Paris. Now this Paris is a troll. Rocket is physical special first. Alright, got it. Never mind. Yeah, that move would have been hard to line up, but still doable. I can't like exactly practice perfect movement in Mount Moon because the counter rate is what causing the variance. So you just gotta practice reactions at this point. Ooh, I didn't hit the Predicate guy. I did that once in a race. and that was not fun to work with. The good thing is that I actually have Paris in both games now. I did not need to Mega Punch that. So it said special and physical. Hey, it's another Geo-Bro. Let's not press B. Like, is this really 151? Physical and special. Well, it's physical now. I'll take that last damage with bubble instead. Now it's a good time as any other to teach water gun. Has water gun recovered? Probably not. Poisoned. That took too long. I should be able to get out of the cave without issues. Soon, War Turtle will faint. Okay, Freema and Blue for a bit. Hey, it's another Paris. Hey, it's the third Paris. I make sure I got Tele. I know Little King Cry is longer, but sometimes I just can't get the right menus to time the menu. Unless I get into this fight here. But this allows me to get free movement in Blue for a bit too. So it's like kind of a trade-off where whichever I decide to go with. Of when to evolve Needle King. Like, I can probably evolve a ball in the middle of this fight. But I have to fight against movement. Can't afford the Parasis here. I'm thinking I should heal. Go with water gun because it's just more accurate. Wow, encounters, please. I got enough. I literally got enough. I beat the fight in like before I even walk all the way to the rocket. I don't need a Leer. And that's a Tail Whip for it, in case she X defense first turn. So now I need like 3 Tail Whips on this Starmie here, which is a long time to set up. A lot of damage can be dealt in that time. Like that, those crits, especially with Starmie's high space speed. It's 2. And then I have to heal. So that's the 3 I need. She still has an X defend, which is nice. I'm just gonna heal one more. There's the X defend. I couldn't get the extra damage in this case. But I'd just rather be safe and not die. Okay, this is a good time to teach Bubble Beam. Bye, Tail Up. Since they're so close to each other, I'll just do this. Simultaneous healing. But one has extra one more Pokemon, which is expected. But then at least you do this next again. Yeah, that's the way I like it. Simultaneous movements. I feel I should save before this fight always, because sand attack and sand attack is gonna be an issue. Whoops, that's not what I want to save. The one game will have advantage over the other, finishing faster. Nice, there we go. See, that sand attack. Okay, then I'll switch to Pidgey. So I could get rid of the sand attack status. Man, this rival's going in. Oh no, that's not the attack I wanted. Whoops. I was thinking of Nidoking there for a bit. Ugh, that was not a good idea. Don't crit. Okay, good. Wow, Lulu finished first. That's not what I expected to happen. I'm expecting Red to finish first. And you had made one mistake in blue. This is expected to be two turns, or take two turns. Let's mega punch that. Beam. That's right. Right. Okay, I'm gonna heal on this fight now. As long as I keep hitting the hard attacks, it should be good. Or that works too. And also, don't forget to use rare Kennys in red after this fight. I tend to forget that quite a bit. Especially when there's like so many things can happen at the same time, at different times. It's not like I say, after I complete this in blue, make sure you write candy. No, no, that doesn't work. Oh, I didn't hit it. Alright, I hit this horn attack. I didn't want to use Bubble Beam there, but whatever. Okay, good. Didn't do anything wrong there. Although getting rid of poison wouldn't be too terrible. I'll use two bargains here instead. I might have to switch a Bubble Beam in that second one. That looks a bit. Thrash. See, Nidoking is a lot easier because the move selection is not as varying compared to blue. I want to use Mega Punch somewhere. Thrash. Probably on the Zubat here then. Okay, that works too. I think now I should have enough. Why am I blinking? Bubble Beam. Please don't miss. Okay, good. I'll start this fight soon. Good. Now I can move freely in blue to get this. Down. I like that a little bit of what to do there, but I got it now. Nice that I hit it in one hit. Nice crit. Nice crit. Wow. Oh yeah, that's right, there's a fight here, I have to pay attention to. I'm trying to look at my notes for a bit. next move in red for a bit. So I can get through this fight, and now I can really just do this in blue now. A range there. That's not a range I like to see. Ooh. Okay, good, I got my bite. I do want to blue be slightly ahead, but it's okay, it's not that far ahead. That's fine. In fact, I'll just do them at the same time instead. Actually, no, I can't. That does not work. Actually, yeah, let's do that. I have not tried it out yet. This. I mean, the pace at sub 255 is incredible. I still didn't think it was that easy, but apparently it is. Oh, wait. Escape route is in different slots, wouldn't it? Yeah, they are. Okay, I'll take that. So it's just better if I separate them then. Good to know now. Alright, it just makes it a lot easier overall. But this fight is gonna be pretty quick. Yeah, Misty's scary also here too for Needle King. I don't know if my stats is good enough. I did not want to use second ball unit, but it wouldn't let me select another move anyways. Whatever. Nice. Just don't crit. Nice. I feel that healing is not a bad idea. Nice, I got the jingle skip. Well, I was not trying to. The fact that the red room had to move up a bit makes that kind of hard to get out of the way for that. And what can I do? That's a range? I thought it was that it's a one hit. Maybe I was wrong. Maybe I could be wrong, but my Neo stats is not that great either. Okay, let's go for another heal. And teach TM 11. Okay, good. I know it's far away, but I mean, like, I have to move farther to beach him anyways. Get the jingle skip in red. Yes, I got the jingle skip. No. There we go. Okay, now hope for the flinch. It's not required, but just hope. I need to buy 7 and 3. Okay, a little lead here. I mean, I'll get what I take. Okay, good. Walk over a little bit so I could get to here. It's do the same shopping. Let's see it. I don't think that's going to affect the money for red for big. Red actually has more money than blue in regardless, because they actually take a little bit more fights. Did I teach all the moves I need to teach? No, I did not. Shoot, I forgot to. That's what I forgot to do, to teach the two moves while I was fighting in red. Okay, good. And well, I might as well start the same fight at the same time. But I still need them to be slightly different. Shoot. That's what I thought. They got synced up. Don't die, don't die. Maybe I could have thrashed there earlier. Don't crit. Okay, good. I should try to save for this fight in the marathon. This might be a mistake, thinking like this, but I mean, I never tried. Because the trash can is going to be different between both games, and I do want to fight Surge at the same time, it's just trash cans are trash cans. Also, I want to heal. That actually would desync the game, healing. Because super potions are not in the same slots. Unless... No, they actually are the same. Watch. Go from the bottom up 3. Like that. See? Because Squirtle needs to be... Wartortle needs to be at full health. Oh, menus. Menus. I forgot about menus, that's why. Okay, so... I need to teach Cut to my Paris, my lovely, lovely Paris, and move my repels, and then teach Dig in one. And teach it to Squirtle. And this is how I can desync cans away from there, please. Not the one I'd like to see. Okay, I got that one easily done. Okay, that's the one I like to see. Their middle name is Claude. Cool trainer Michael Claude Kappa. Oh, I forgot to sync up their moves here. What? Why? Alright. Nice. They got these things just a bit, but in time. Yeah, just in time to sync up the fight. Don't die, don't die, don't die. Okay, good. What? Okay, never mind. My special on attack on Squirtle is so bad that it got into a range now for Raichu. I'm still ahead in PB ish. And somehow Blue didn't take some inputs where Red did. Alright, so I need no Sonic Boom. Okay, that's good. That's not the move I wanted. I was thinking of the wrong Pokemon. Wrong move selection. Alright, movement selection. Alright, hope. Hashtag hope. Just hope. Okay, not bad time loss, not that bad. Definitely can be made up. Wow. Blue just sometimes just drops inputs. I do not know why. It's always been blue. It's not like it's, I don't know, it's game dependent or console dependent. Whoops. So I'm like baffled by dropping inputs. Maybe I should just switch the console around. That's not a bad option to test that. I'm gonna take this free heal too. Might need all the body slams I can get. Only my DV is that bad. Good. This fight can be scary. More so for blue than red. Because of my lower attack. So much text boxes there. I mean, it's a chance to... Well, that's not really much of a chance. No, I think it's only crit only. This one's a range for Bellsprout. That's fine. Okay. Don't be fully. Hi, hello there, Gibleo. Wrap. Finish. Now. 5-turn wrap, please. Why? Okay. That is the range I was scared about. I can't do anything about that either. Okay. God damn. And just to be safe. Okay, I need to desync their moves here. Like that. Okay, this is expected to be two range though. Okay, good one to disable. Oh, two hits for both. Alright, now I have to be careful with this move here in case one of them does get desynced. There we go. Down. For marathon, I'll save here. And time to go through the dark. I should be in the same exact spot now for both, which is good. That's what's needed for a fight like this. They both gonna use water moves, which surprisingly they're both, it's in the second slot for both. Turns out it could be in the same slot. Okay, now I need to sync these two apart. Maybe I could just use Thrash. But Thunderbolt is just safer. Desync. Ooh, I did not see that coming. Alright, this is the next scary fight for War Turtle. Cause here I can hit a couple ranges like that. Okay, good. That's what I wanted to see. That's fine. I make some extra movements in red when I didn't want to. So this is the very easy fight here. It's all Geodudes and like Graveler. I mean Geobros and Graveler. And my water move is in the second slot, so it's just like spam the water move. And sync them up like that. I think one of them levels up. Yep. That's the only problem about this fight, that one of them actually gets leveled up. Oh, after that, but the fight's just easy overall. Just make sure one of them doesn't get off at one. Okay, perfect. Nice range. That's okay. Even if he poisoned me, I still have antidotes. Which would be the more preferred... God damn it. Not the move I wanted. Yeah, definitely not the move I wanted to hit. Okay, got to it. I'm gonna use my water move for this double fire type here. Waiting for a Vulpix. Nice quick attack. Two turns for Neo King in the end. It's fine. Alright, inch my movement here. So that way I don't hit that girl. Should be around here. I went too early. I counted too early. Now, I depend on NPCs here to desync the movements between the two games. Like that. So Ray gets the pleasure of doing shopping first. Pokeballs. Potions. course she would. Now she moves down. Forgot that I should move down to walk around that. Like, I gotta remember that more. Okay, shopping is not as tight as it was before, but still not enough to forgo a second trip. Okay, now I can do blue menus. Super potion. Wait, why is super? It should be super repel. I'm thinking so off. Accuracy, then special to doll, I believe. Okay, that's speed, attack, full, elixir, super. Your turn. So I want my 11 repels here. Alright. Horn drill. Then move my X accuracy here. Then I want to teach Rock Slide. Yeah, not Ice Beam. Then move the special. Move the doll right under the special. Speed, attack, full elixir, super. Where are my super potions? If I did this right, it'd be that. Skip that. Okay, menu is basically done. Move all the way up for repels and fly. Ooh, they went at the same time. They're like maybe about like one frame off. Anyways, I'm gonna use the same 2x items here. It's accuracy for New King and special for War Turtle. And depending on what move he picks, I can pick one. And I can't. I was too slow. Ice Beam should be fine here against the Growlithe. Especially if he's not resisting against ice, because it's Gen 1 after all. Oh yeah, you gotta be careful not to move in red. So these next couple fights are pretty easy. They are going to be, one's going to use Dig, the other's using Rock Slide, and they're both in the fourth slot, so it makes it really easy to select. As long as I don't miss, this fight should be good, or these fights. Although Rock Slide has a good chance of missing. Now the problem is that also Dig takes 2 turns, so it's gonna take more turns overall. Get some free elixir. And another free elixir. I tried to sync the ending there, but I couldn't. Let's try this again. One more try. Aww. We got desync there. There we go. Because the beauty of the music is so important after all. Controller, why? Why are you doing this to me now? If I recall correctly, the only item I need in this three rockets is just the X-Act on the second one. Checking real quick, and that is correct. Hi, CTM. You know the answer to that. Kappa. We'll see this one hits for both. Nope. That could be bad for War Turtle. I have to admit, like, okay, so when I took a class in of computer science in my high school years, we were doing a computer lab, but there were so little of us that there's like a ratio of 5 computers to 1 person. What do you think? What I did is just, why not just control 3 of them, play the same song from 3 of them all at the same time, all synchronized. Wasn't easy, because they're playing it by ear. So I can't verify it was all exactly the same time, but they were pretty close. And it's, of course, since then, that's been quite a while ago. Quite a long time ago. I kind of like do that once in a while. This one's the one I'm touching. Hey, stashing about. Ah, there we go. Synchronized right to the end. Boom. A little off. I know, I forgot to split. There you go. But I'm at least 8 minutes ahead. That timing of the repellent wearing out there. Good thing about Pokeflutes in the same exact slot at the very end. Oh, I forgot to do something. I need to use a repel. So I gotta do it after the fight. Am I off? I can't be off. Alright, I was off. I thought it was one higher. Now I can relax my hand for a bit. Thankfully. And it's taking a nice repel wearing off. Shoot. That's not what I wanted to do. Yeah, I forgot that I used a repel later, not earlier. Now I'm gonna play this by ear. Now, I usually move to here and time to desync their menu so I can use. This is Ice Beam, right? Over the fourth slot. And that should be the only thing I need to use. Moving the X item. Like that. Should be here. Okay, got it. After birth, its back swells into and hardens into a shell, powerfully spraying foam from its mouth. Okay, good to know. Since I used my repel early, I'll use one late, but I don't know where late, because I used it early there. Never used it early there till now. Move. Oh god. I might not make it through all the grass. One more bit. Okay, we're safe. I thought there was one more after that. Movement. Why? You see that, like, boots just doesn't move sometimes. I don't have an explanation for that. I should rewire my console so that I can see what's happening exactly. Like, that would help a lot if I just rewire it. This one is just thrash and surf. Nice crit! I could do this early then. I can do this. No more thrash. I can't tell which music is which now. I know, like, the tunes. I just can't tell which game it's coming from. So now I have two ground moves, but the problem is that Neo King is in the first slot and the boss is in the second, fourth slot, so I need to desync them. But can I desync them? That's the real question. And that all depends on blast on this. Nope. Okay, controller, please? Controller? So I'm sitting here just because this fight can be scary with a lot of setup that's going to be done. It's like, X Act, X Speed, and 4 X Specials. Also, I might range like the Alakazam if my DB is 0 or something like that. Okay, good. So Blastoise gone through. Well, there's 2 tough ones left. And this Lapras is for my last HM I need, called Strength. I could teach it to Squirtle and Nidoking, but it's like, then it gets, terrible menus for me in the end, so I was like, let's save the time by getting Paris, and get better menus overall. That's why I need a desync, so let's hope for the desync. I did not get the desync I wanted. I think we'll work there, but it's like, let's choose Surf. Because why not? So here is very basically exact menu selections, even the moves are different. X hack, X special, and then the second slot being surf and horn drill. Good thing he didn't poison like my unlike my last run at this point. Okay, I can sink the fight at this point. Wow, that crit added the text box that was needed. Like that. And here is the first fight where I needed X accuracy for Needle King. This very same thing is like they both have the same menu selection. Huh, they both withdraw. Doesn't matter to me. You're gonna die. And you can see how Biosam just finishes faster overall. Because of the screen shake versus screen flash. Screen shake versus the flash on the bulk one. This is a very prime example where you can put them side by side and look at it. The reason for that, moves that have... I don't like that HP for for Blastoise mostly. Yeah. Anyways, what was I gonna say now? Oh yeah, screen shake and screen flash. That moves that do have secondary effects shake the screen, and flash is only for moves without secondary effects. Hi there, Glitchy Mew Man. Purposely waiting. Cause why not sweep them up as much as I can? Ooh, this could be a 3-turn, which I might not expect that. Yeah, 3-turn. It's fine. Oops, I didn't mean to hit 0 there, which is my split button. Or my numpad 0 is my split button. I'm going to hit right to screw all my notes. This is mostly the same move selection until the last Pokemon. But it's fine either way. Accuracy and special. Mm-hmm. The only thing is that New King's gonna finish much faster, as you can see. This Muk is already taking two turns. Hornjo is gonna take one turn regardless. Just go boom, 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 boom. Nope, he didn't boom. Crit. What'd he do? What'd he do? He sludged. He boomed. See, I'll take that. Now the poison ticks is gonna just annoy me like this, but what can I do about that? I mean, I could heal it away, but I'm gonna use Mom Heal for that. Ooh! Okay, let's go here. Yeah, I was at actually low HP this time, so he fainted much sooner. So I hope you understand what's the concept behind the, me running this. It's, I'm playing both games at the same time using one controller. So both games get the same exact inputs at the same exact time. It leads to very interesting executions that's needed. Ideally, the fastest way is to use both Neo Kings, but that's just less interesting. Say, why not just make them both different? Oh, that's what I didn't do earlier. I should have lined up the rare candies. No, I did not mean to do that. I want them to be at the same level, so let's do this. Lol. Actually, that could be bad. Let's do this now. Okay, that's fine. These double inputs are happening more often than I like. I mean, Glitchy Mew Man, if you ever seen the first hour 15 minutes, it's like, it's a complete mess if you were to watch that. Then everything after that is like, it's very well, looks much more organized. Which makes it great to do this kind of run for Pokemon. It has both aspects of that at the same time. Not intentionally done like that, but it just turns out it could be done. I wish, like, the other games, there's just more viable Pokemon to, use. I mean, not the other but the other gens. So I need to practice Rare Candy, because I kept the Rare Candy on the wrong one so many times. Oh, that's just rather unlucky there. Yeah, that's a unfortunate part where I didn't use the rare candy. I mean, I still have Repel and all, but it only attracts Pokemon that's level 41 and, or it detracts level 41 Pokemon and lower. So, the 1% chance still can happen. This is usually the menu I would... would teach strength in. Not to be trigger happy. There we go. Now onward to Blaine. Yeah, only X accuracy needed here. Yeah, my repel count's now all messed up. I'm not using Splitter. I'm using a Wavebird controller. Like, Splitter... there is no controller Splitter. There is no such thing. Someone wants to rig one up. And even so, if they can rig it up, will it work on different consoles? That's the other issue. The other thing is that the game inherently has variable input lag, so that means the inputs can come on different frames for each game, which I cannot control. I'm actually better press A on here. I'm using the Wavebird controller, using two receivers. I did the quiz correctly. Now I can't get through Blaine. It might be because like how my computer is in between the controller and the Wavebird receivers is an issue. It could be that because I mean there can be interference that was introduced. Wait a minute. That's not what I wanted to do. I was talking too much. Quick, please. And two turns for Arcanine. And I can sync up the fight like this. Now it's time for Sabrina. Good controller. What a wonderful controller I have. Kappa. At the rate this is going, yeah, this is probably going to be the first verified console run with one death so far, and that being Surge. Saving just in case. Sabrina can troll a little bit, because I am setting up on the Mr. Mime. Oh wait, not yet. That would have been a bad idea to set up on this part of the fight. Rip barrier. Nice miss. Okay, can I get the second body slam in time? Yes, now I can sync it up right here. Because syncing is just fun. Even for time losses. Yeah, that time lapse probably came from lava from Mansion. Now to do shopping round 2. Unlike normal glitchless, I need a second set of X items to buy. One round is not enough to buy it from. I didn't correct move it this time, so I need to buy 5, 6, 5. That sounded kind of weird. Now, these fights are going to be relatively easy. Just Ice Beam, Ice Beam, and Ice Beam. Let's see, question is, can I sync them up? Yes, I can. Like that. whatever. Nothing I could do about that. I forgot I should desync. Hey there, Revenor. There we go. A little light split. Now I will teach Blizzard so I can also get the Fissure next. And it should be over Body Slam, yeah. Besides, I'm going to get a nice PB in this, and I'm using this to practice for a marathon. And this is possibly, if everything goes right, would be my first console PB. Let's do that, re-enter this again. What do you mean by what are my splits? I'm comparing to my PB. As far as I'm aware of, I'm the only runner for this category, so I have both world record and being the only runner. Oh, before it was my emulator. At the time, I didn't have the consoles ready to set up this, so now I do. I'm using console over emulator, because this is very much doable on console after all. Yeah, that's right. Yep, I'm ready. I'm gonna be very excited for Red, Blue, Yellow on the 3DS. Though I don't know how we're gonna do two games with controller on the 3DS though, Kappa. It is possible, but that's a lot more money to invest. Like, a whole lot of money. Just gain two 3DSs with capture cards? That's a big haul right there. Okay, good. The movement synced up. Okay, that's why I do want the game to desync a bit, because the move selection is going to be quite different between the two. Not quite different, but it is different enough. Bum, 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 Bum bum. Bum. Yeah, Ice Beam starting first for the first two. Then we went to something stronger next. Cheese the gym like what? What do you mean? You mean like reload the gym? And skip all the other trainers? Is that what you're saying? Oh, I forgot to split for Giovanni again. Controller, please. One of each. The consoles, yeah, they can desync. I haven't figured out why yet. Let's put it that way. Last Ice Beam. I probably should heal and save before this fight. Probably always a good idea to save before the fight. Plus we'll kill this Growlithe. I see a glitchy Mew Man. There we go. Synced up. thanks for the host, JT. Oh, bring in those Kevin Turtles. So how's the runs today, GT? For, I believe it was Heart Gold or Soul Silver? I know it's a Gen 2 remix. Lapras is down here. Question is, will the run sub 250 now? I see. And still out on practice at this part though. Oh god, the movement. The repels are gonna be desynced now. Oh no. Movement. Okay, let's go mostly on this part so I don't run into her or the tricky. Cause the controller can desync at any moment, which sucks like that. Just use a repel here, and then use strength. Right. Problem is, I don't have, like, positional audio, so I don't know, like, which game is coming from which when it gets desynced. First, like, water movement. So I have to play by eye, which can take a little bit while to respawn. Please, GT. Blastoise is not gonna be in Torrent forever, Kappa. I wanted to say hi to everybody, but I mean, it was a raid, so it's kind of hard to see the chat scroll by. I have a small chat box to look at. Blue, move! Sometimes Blue just doesn't respond to my wave bird. And I don't know why. And just to let you guys know, this is also on console. So this is very much console verified. Movement. Movement. Blue! Stop trolling me! You're trolling me too hard. This is painful to look. I do not know why the consoles do that yet. It's not that Blue lags more. I mean, I tested this on emulator for quite a bit. Whoops, how did that get there? Please, Rafael, don't run out. So rip like a good minute or so. I don't know how long that was. But that was just... I don't know. What I need to do is move the consoles in front of me so I can see if inputs are just getting delayed or not. Right. And also misbought one of the repels. So I need to take up the menus, is the main thing. That's why I bought extra repels, because I don't know, I can always move it like that really bad. Also, I'm practicing this all for an upcoming marathon called the Californiathon. It's coming up in March at Easter weekend. I'm not gonna release them. Hey there, man. Andy Mexico SD. You got some time. But yeah, the hard part is to find the motivation. But definitely, you should practice up for that. For me, it's just the hard part of getting things to work in my favor. To run like this. So I'm saving for here because Lorelei can troll me in the first turn with the crit Aurora Beam on Nidoking. And I'm very excited for Californiathon. Mm-hmm. Pretty sure I need a speed here too. Don't crit. Okay. Attack ball does not matter. Speed. Fissure is on the bottom, so I want to put it there. So I put it up two. I messed it up. I've miscounted one. And then I can do this. So I can press A like this easily. Bruno in the next fight is going to be quite different, because I'm going to use different moves for both majority of his Pokemon. That double talk. Okay, spicing it up at least. Ooh, I forgot to use an item here. But I can use it in the fight. Should not be a problem. Just a little bit more time waste. And forgot to split there, like I usually do. Beam. Surf. Yeah, and it sticks up right here. Not intentionally though. Goddamn Hydro Pump, I forgot that was there. Ooh, I forgot to heal. This can go bad. So let's just heal in here. And let's see what she does. Hypnosis is not what I wanted to see. So I'll have to use a Pokeflute that's exactly in the same slots. Wow. The thing is, I want to set the XMs at the same exact time. So I don't get confused later. Okay, that's the two important ones I need. Before she switches. Of course, it can happen. Should have taken the sign from that she just kept hypnosising me for a while. I'm still gonna PB. The time measurement is RTA. Not, in-game time. I'll just deal with this first. Then heal later. If I need to. Speed. She uses Gold Bat there, so I could use Blizzard here. Of course, I would hurt myself in confusion. Why? That haze. Probably like Blastoise and Agatha's. Blastoise needs all the turns to set up. Oh. Okay, this is why I'll heal. That's fine. I use an X-Ack, so now I go to Special in case she switches to Golbat. Right, I will use a flute, so this doesn't use Beam Meter on me. And doesn't use Hypnosis, good. Confuse Rays on both again. Need to sync their movesets. Good, good. Nah, as long as I get through the gold bat, I think we should get all the way through. Oh, hey there, IMAX. I was thinking of Blizzard there. It's only for the gold bat. Hey IMAX, have you put any consideration to come down for Californiathon? I mean, the submissions are ore, but you can always come down to, just to attend. There is no admission charge. And I would love to have you there for, like, commentary for my run. Escaping that split. Yeah, I forgot to hit the split, but it's whatever. Alright, here's hoping. It can go bad in both ways. Special. Okay, it went bad in one way. I gotta count my deaths after this. This is a lot of deaths, I can say that. Please don't crit either of them. Either of them crits, I die. Nice frozen. I could use this moment to have XP for both. Did I miss a blizzard there? Let's see. Need to desync them quite quickly. Just wait. There you go. Heal to full, and then restore all my PP. Extra elixirs there for in case I mess up one of the move selections, which I did not in this case. I will try to sync this fight as best as I can, and you'll see how. Especially the sync rival music, it's so much better. Okay, do not crit sky attack. That's an instant death. Don't crit, don't crit, don't crit. Okay, good. The question is, where do I do it at? Here it is. There we go. See, I can get up like that. One more Pokemon. But the timing is not over yet. Timing is over when the screen fades to credits. There's a slight desync there. There we go. And it's only one Pokemon in the show. And time. There we go. Good old PB. And the first PB on console. So, yeah, this is my run of Pokemon Red Blue 2 games on my controller. Lots of hard work, lots of deaths in this fight. Like, I died to once to Surge. I survived Misty, surprisingly. So I died to Surge. I died to... Where else did I die to? Besides the Elite Four. I know I lost time somewhere. No, Surge. Blaine had some input mishaps. denying three times to Agatha, one time to Lance, if I recall correctly. We're gonna rate someone with this. I know who I'm gonna raid. But before we do that, let's get I am working to play this game these games into a marathon. And the marathon is gonna be at twitch.tv/californiathon. And now let's get the raid message ready. And let's go raid. Where is he? I thought I saw him go on. Yeah, he is on. Yeah, if you're new to my stream, make sure you give me a follow. Thank you all for watching, and good night, and go raid Exarion.